face of the city makes many feel anonymous, lost in the crowd. Graffiti writing is one way adolescents fight this urban anonymity.
Popularity, what is it made of? How does a person get to be popular with lots of people and have a few close friends too? Let's watch and see what makes people like one person and not another.
You see the balls grinning, I'm loving these women. I let two get in, she tried to let the rest fit in. I'm like, no, love, that's forbidden. I ain't for squishing, that's a problem to the wheel. Well, trust, I know them 20s real well. Now we coasting, me two chicks and toasting. I turn up the volume, watch the bass get them open. Soft spoken, with a wild side. I love them in the ride, they love it in the ride. We was moving bodies before we hit the party, before the DJ started cutting. Cinderella, you girls from nothing to something. Hit the parking lot, hear the club system thumping. Lose the face, you twos was great, but it's to the VIP, I got new moves to make.
When the last time you heard it like this? Smoke some, drink some, get ripped.
If there is such a thing as an average graffiti artist, he is male and between the ages of 12 and 16. Most often is asked the question, why do these kids go to so much trouble just to write their names? There are several reasons. First of all, graffiti writing has become a sport, like handball or stickball, to make life on the street more interesting. At the very least, it's a challenge to be met. To some, writing has become more than a sport. It is an art and an important part of their lives. There is a strict code of ethics that is adhered to by the more serious artists. It is considered bad sportsmanship, for example, to work over what other writers consider to be a masterpiece, or to copy someone's style, or steal someone's name. Another reason for this fascination with graffiti is seeing your name on a wall or moving by on a train. Graffiti writing becomes both an act of destruction and of possession of a social order which breeds boredom and rebellion. It permits the birth of a new and larger-than-life identity and is one way of making one's mark on society.
Picture with the president, I just wanna talk to the man. Speak for the boys in a bando, and my nigga never walking again. Apologize if I'm harping again, I know these things happen often, but I'm back on the scene. I was lost in a dream as I write this to teen down in Austin. I've been building me a house back home in the South, ma, won't believe what it's costing. And it's fit for a king, right, or a nigga that can sing and explain all the pain that it cost him. My 16 should've came with a coffin, for the fame and the fortune. Well, maybe not the fortune, but one thing is for sure, the fame is exhausting. That's why I moved away, I needed privacy, surrounded by the trees in Ivy League. Students that's recruited higher league, thinking you do you and I do me. Crib has got a big old back of yard, my niggas stand outside and pass cigars, filled with marijuana, laughing hard. Thankful that they friends a platinum star. In the driveway there's no rapper cars, just some shit to get from back and forth. Just some shit to get from back and forth. Welcome to the shelter, this is pure. We'll help you if you felt too insecure to be the star you always knew you were. Wait, I think police is at the door.
Okay, the neighbors think I'm selling dope.
guess the neighbors think I'm selling dope. Selling dope. Neighbors think I'm selling dope. The neighbors think I'm selling dope. Guess the neighbors think I'm selling dope. Selling dope, selling dope, selling dope, selling dope.
Motherfucker, I am.
Some things you can't escape. Death, taxes, and a rape. This society to make every nigga feel like a candidate for a Trayvon kind of fate. Even when your crib sit on a lake, even when your plaques hang on a wall, even when the president jammed your tape, took a little break just to annotate how I feel. Damn, it's late. I can't sleep cause I'm paranoid. Black in a white man territory. Cops bust in with the army guns. No evidence of the harm we done. Just a couple neighbors that assume we slang. Only time they see us, we be on the news and change. Damn.
They're both a rebellion of, against what's going on, what they don't like. This isn't my world. This is my world. Here's where I live. You wanna join my world? You have to talk my talk. Act like me. They believe that there is a lack of respect towards them. And in that lack of respect, the only thing to hand back is lack of respect. And the only way to do it is the quiet way.
Little boy, he was up in the roof and then he fell down because he was in the roof flying a kite.
When he was falling, he grabbed onto the clothesline. And the clothesline pulled him, did not.
No. All of them broke, and then when he fell, his body was full of blood.
The streets are unsafe, the papers say, full of muggers and rapists and purse snatchers. Fear is cement for the wall that keeps this neighborhood off limits. But the people who live here walk the streets after dark and see only their neighbors. Even junkies are not anonymous or faceless. They too are neighbors. Only they suffer more. And in the bars, old-timers who cannot look forward, look backward.
I remember as a little child. I'm saying a child, 12 years old. There used to be an old band that used to play up on a band top. Where did that house go? It just disappeared from the neighborhood.
On a midsummer night, a mobile theater brings Garcia Lorca to a schoolyard uptown, and people see their lives costumed into a carnival. Here's an audience ready for make-believe. They wait hours to see free theater, or pay $2 and stand four deep to laugh at Latin vaudeville. Lorca or soap opera, they respond. The night is alive with the culture, of the culturally deprived.
It is not easy to have a home where a man has lost this image of himself. Home is not to him as important as it was or it would have been. He goes out, he congregates in the corners to talk and whatnot. He goes on the sidewalk, sits there with his three or four more and play dominoes. She could be in love with him or whatnot, but if he's not a man anymore, there's nothing else there. That's how we look at it anyway.
Hey,
over some they got a hat and a mouse ran up the stairs.
Yo, man, stop right there. You messed up. Run it back, okay?
See, I'm about to get the show, so don't be trying to knock me. I say what I want to say. I smoke this, it sounds funky. Some of these wanted to buy me, so they try to take stairs. But they don't understand. I'm the Mr. Funky Man. I demand and I'm down. Look them up and down. Smack a few of them around. Let them know who was the drunk. Who's the tip of the drop, the king of the crop, the best under the sun. I'm the Lord Chief Rocker number one. Mr. Funky, Boom Shaka Rocker, yo, here comes the hit.
Subway graffiti has been a New York tradition for so long that taggers can refer to the good old days when trains were rolling canvases. The chance to relive the past brought two generations of taggers to this New York screening of Style Wars, a film about the origins of the outlaw movement. These days, taggers bold enough to bomb trains are up against a transit system determined to keep subway graffiti from public view.
Now, if you get your name seen on a train, they know it's risky.
To stay ahead of the transit system, taggers, like these members from a crew called CBS, take photos of their handiwork.
I'm assuming that this is no longer on this train.
It could have ran for a day.
More and more taggers are relying on video, thanks to the help of graffiti bomber turned producer Carl Weston.
If you do a train now, more than likely you're doing it to get the recognition. You're going there with two cans of spray paint and a camera. After you do your own throw up, you take a picture of it. It doesn't matter whether it runs or not, because it's going to run in videograph.
We are planning to be top and bottom, so we need a little time to stay there.
Since 1989, Weston has produced and distributed 7 videos featuring taggers from around the country.
This is the stuff from Sacramento.
Sacramento, yeah. Like this guy right here got busted. $10,000 fine.
Much of the footage in Videograph focuses on teenagers involved in the growing practice of tagging moving subway trains, what graffiti artists call motions.
Jay, train coming from the other side. Jay, train's coming from the other side, bro. Hurry up.
I wasn't even that crazy. when I was his age. This is his claim to fame.
Jay, after this, jet down and I'll meet you, alright? Downstairs, Jay. What? Get out of here, Jay!
So, in a way, you're promoting graffiti.
Oh, yeah, we are. There's no ifs or ands about it. I promote graffiti.
What about people who say, you know, that's all well and good, I guess, but A, it's illegal, and B, it's like a blight on society.
All I can say is that it is just a natural progression of a graffiti writer. There's nothing they can do to stop kids from doing this once they get hooked. It's an addiction. It is truly an addiction.
Officials from the New York Transit Authority refuse to talk to us. They believe that stories like ours encourage graffiti vandalism. But even taggers admit that the Transit Authority seems to be winning the battle against subway graffiti. The battle, not necessarily the war. For some taggers, taking the kind of chances involved in riding on trains means winning more respect from their peers.
The kids who hit trains are the ones with the heart.
Go is trying a new tack to control tagging. It filed suit against the mother of a 17-year-old arrested for defacing dozens of buses and buildings. The city wants her to pay $7,000 for the damage.
Hey, look, whatever it is, just forget about it. Life is too short. You should try to be happy.
Well, what if you can't make yourself happy?
Then I don't know. You know what you do then? You forget. Block it out. I remember my grandmother told me how to be happy. Said, Leon, my darling little grandson, if you want to be happy, don't think. Don't bump into any walls. If you stutter, don't talk. I listened to my grandmother, and look at me now. Couldn't be happier. Well,